Hey guys, so we're going to use the discriminant to determine whether the equation has two rational solutions, one rational solution, two irrational solutions, or two non-real complex solutions, and we're not actually going to solve. So in number 60, we have 4y squared equals 6y minus 7. So let's talk about what the discriminant is. The discriminant is what's under the radical inside of the quadratic formula. X equals the opposite of b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So it's going to be this b squared minus 4ac. That's what we call the discriminant. The discriminant here is going to tell us what type of solutions we're actually going to get when we solve the quadratic formula when we plug in the appropriate values. If the discriminant is equal to 0, then you're going to have one rational solution. If the discriminant is less than 0, then you're going to have two non-real complex solutions. If the discriminant is greater than 0, then you can go one of two ways. If it's a perfect square, for example 25, then you'll have two rational solutions. If it's not a perfect square, for example 7, then you'll have two irrational solutions. Here in number 60, we have 4y squared equals 6y minus 7. So let's go ahead and figure out what's our a, what's our b, and what's our c. So first we have to put this in ax squared plus bx plus c form. And here we have y squared. So I'm going to change this formula so that instead of x squared, it says y squared. Now let's set everything equal to 0 so we can match up our terms. So let's subtract 6y and add 7 to both sides. That way we can cancel out everything on the right hand side, making 0. And then on the left, we're left with 4y squared minus 6y plus 7. And now we see that our a is 4, our b is negative 6, and our c is 7. Plugging that into our discriminant, we get negative 6 squared minus 4 times 7. Negative 6 squared is 36. Let's bring down our negative, and 4 times 4 times 7 is 112. 36 minus 112 is negative 76. Negative 76 is a negative number, therefore it is less than 0. So we are going to have two non-real complex solutions. And that's our answer.